Okay, so this is the 1.8k Rover engine out of the Freelander and various other cars. Now, I'll just say that I'm not an expert on doing timing belts. I've done about 20 in the past and two of them have failed, so it's a bit of a tricky job, and for 120 quid that you get them done these days, it might be worth getting a professional to do. But I'm just going to talk about this one because I've done a few of these in the past. And these ones are quite easy to do in a roundabout way. Obviously this engine's out of the motor, so it's a lot easier. But first of all, you got to line these marks. In fact, that comes off there. Obviously it locates on the crankshaft, so it can be timed. You got two dots there. Now them two dots have to be lined up with that line there. See it? And when you do that, that will mean your pistons are all midway in the barrel. They're all halfway, they're all level, but at the midway point. And sometimes you have to set them at top dead centre, but on this engine, you set them two dots to that line, and it's midway. Then you set the inlet. You line these two marks up here, as you can see, and your inlet should be put into your inlet, and your exhaust should be put into your exhaust side. So these two marks here, exhaust inlet in the centre, and the inlet to that side, the exhaust to that side. Then you undo your timing tension holder and this one, and that's how you set your tension. But anyway, I'm going to put the belt in place, which is a two-handed job, and then just tighten it up and then show you the marks where they should be. If I'm correct, make sure you check out any manuals and any online sites or whatever information. I don't want to be responsible for your engine damage. Like I say, I've had two failures in the past, so study up. Okay, so my camera recorder bus, so I'm doing it on a different camera now. Basically, in a 6mm Allen key, a 10mm bolt, a 10mm socket, doing your timing tensions. I think my timing tension's a bit bust there, so you would have to undo that one and do it up, but I ain't going to worry about that. And I'm not rebuilding this engine, so it don't matter. So that's your timing tension, fastening. And then to move your camshaft, your camshafts are 17mm. I'm just going to turn the crank with the flywheel. So I'm going to do that now and get these to top to the midway point, the timing marks on this cam crank sprocket. So there you go, as you can see, the top two marks in line with that. Looks a bit funny on the photo, and it might be slightly out of line, I'll just check that now. So there's the cams aligned, the exhaust of the inlet here, with these two marks aligned, the inlet facing the inlet and the exhaust facing the exhaust. That's the way I've been told how to do it. So do your research on that, because I obviously haven't got to build this engine back up, so I've got no 100% proof. So do your research. So that is pretty much it now. The timing chain is all around. Timing belt. Now you just gotta tension it. Once this is maximum tension, tighten up the 10mm bolt there, which I'll have to do now two-handed. And that is it. Now it looks pretty easy, but for 120 quid, It might be best just to take it to a professional. I would, personally. For the product, for 120 quid, you're going to get 200,000 miles, well, no, sorry, 100,000 miles out of it. Or at least 80, so. Is it worth doing yourself? I've done them in the past on cheap cars, but when you're talking about a £2,000-£3,000 car, 120 quid for 80,000 miles don't sound too bad, so leave that to you. But that's how it should be done, as far as I've been led to believe. Two dots here, pistons are midway, inlet to the left, exhaust to the right, these two lines are marked. Tension it, you need. I've been told if you can turn it a quarter way, that is about the right tension. But you can get tools to test the tension, but I ain't got one of them. That's something that a professional brings you, as well as a guarantee. So, there you go.